Hello again, my name is Michael Brown. I'm one of Becker's senior national instructors, and today I'm going to take you through the structure of the CPA exam. Now, in a separate video, I went through the content, what basically is assembled in each of the four sections. This one is designed to give you an overview of the nuts and bolts of the parts of the exam, regardless of the section we're talking about. Now, first and foremost, we need to talk about testlets. So although it is a CPA exam designed to go over 4 hours, it really is five shorter exams given sequentially, testlets 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 in that order. Regardless of the section, the first two are always multiple choice. The question amounts vary slightly. We'll show you that in just a moment. But they're always going to start with multiple choice. That's going to be followed by three testlets, 3, 4, and 5, that are called TBSs, or task-based simulation. You can think of these as more extended problems. We like to say that students should plan on a multiple choice, averaging out to perhaps 90 seconds per question or even a little bit less. Simulations are more on the order of an average of 20 minutes per question to give you a sense of scale. Now, the rules of those arrows that connect each testlet. When you're within a testlet, you can work the questions in any order you like. You can jump around. You can even mark a question to come back to later. But once you submit a testlet, i.e. covering that arrow from 1 to 2 or 2 to 3, you cannot go back. That door closes behind you. Also, those triangles are the only times you're permitted to take a break and leave the testing room during the exam. But note well that with the exception of the one that's flagged here between testlets 3 and 4 as an off-the-clock break, count against your total allocation of 4 hours. The one between testlet 3 and 4 is an additional 15 minutes that is given off the clock, meaning that is the break you should plan on taking because there's no downside to doing so. Note this is also deliberate on the examiner's part because they want that to be roughly halfway through your exam. So in other words, it should take you approximately 2 hours to complete the first three testlets and approximately 2 hours to complete the final two. How about a little bit more background about simulations? Well, they come in a lot of different flavors. The biggest element are what we call traditional simulations. Think of these as any problem, probably not all that different than the ones you've done in college classes. Again, think questions you might have gotten on a midterm or a final that took you 15, 20, 25, perhaps even 30 minutes to complete. But the exam does have some unique types of simulations as well. One is called, well, aptly enough, a document review simulation, where you're asked to review a large number of documentation exhibits and use those exhibits to make edits to a business letter or memorandum. There are research simulations that will ask you to go into the authoritative literature, whether that's the codification, auditing and assurance standards, the Internal Revenue Code, depending on the part of the exam we're talking about, and find the relevant paragraph or the relevant section that addresses a posed question. Now, you may have noticed that testlet 5 is a little bit different. At least it is for one of the four exams, BEC or business. For the business exam, they have swapped out traditional task-based simulations for written communication questions. So these are actually posing business questions where you respond in a business letter or memo, and it's really to test your ability to communicate in the written word. All right, how about those details? So what you'll see here, and I've got them alphabetically, so audit on top, then business, then financial, then regulation. The number of multiple choice does not vary significantly. It goes between 31 on BEC to as many as 38 on regulation. You'll also notice that the number of total simulations does not vary substantially. Audit, financial, and regulation all have 8. BEC is a little different because of the addition or the inclusion of written communication. There, they give you a total of 7. 4 representing traditional or other types like that. You won't find research in business because there is no authoritative literature for the business section. You might find a document review simulation, but expect that more will likely be traditional. But the last 3 that you find in testlet 5 will be that unique written communication type of question. Now, there's one more important thing to know about the exam, the weighting. How much of your score is driven by the different areas of the exam? And it's really easy to keep that in check. It's 50-50. So 50% is driven by the multiple choice questions, effectively your performance on the first two testlets. Half of your score will drive from there. The other 50% will come from the simulation testlets, 3, 4, and 5. So equally important. I hope if nothing else, you take that away from this short video, is that the multiple choice questions as a whole and the simulation questions as a whole are equally important and therefore deserving of equal attention as you prepare for the CPA exam, because both are critically important to passing. So I hope this overview of the structure was beneficial. Appreciate you listening, and I look forward to seeing you on another video soon. Take care.